What's going on, everybody? Welcome to Cafe and Views. Today we went to Coffee Fix and we got their Spanish latte. Let's talk about the coffee shop. Unlike other coffee shops, this isn't on Ventura Boulevard. It's about two streets over, but it still is a busy and popular road. There are a lot of cars and traffic going on. The coffee shop also is pretty busy, even at 3 o'clock, and they close at 4. So it's usually packed around the afternoon. So you might have a better shot going in the morning. Today, when I went, there was no seating outside, but I found a nice location that shows off the coffee shop in the background. You can find ample amount of seating inside if you're trying to get away from the elements or you're trying to get away from the sun and you just want a nice peaceful environment that is not distracted by any cars. The menu is also not as extensive as other coffee shops might be, but there still is a good amount of coffees to choose from. They don't shy away from the norm. They usually stick to the same type of coffees that the normal coffee shops make. They don't have any white chocolate or raspberry. The coffee shop also has snacks that you can get to eat with your coffee. They have other drinks. They also have half their menu coffee, half their menu tea. So if you want to get a kick off caffeine, but you don't want to taste coffee, you can get the tea as well. Really welcoming in there. It makes you feel like a nice coffee shop. You can get a window seat, so you could be looking outside. So for the coffee shop, I'm gonna give this about a 2.5 out of 5. Let's talk about acidity. So because of the cinnamon, I'm getting a nice, sweet, acidic value from this coffee. So there is some sour notes that you can get in this coffee, but it's predominantly sweet. Sourness doesn't affect the quality of the coffee at all, but the sweetness does. The sweetness enhances the flavor and just all the ingredients that went into it. The cinnamon kind of gives it a slight sharp feeling because of the spice in here. If it was just a normal coffee, you would just get like a mellow and a tame feeling, but you're actually getting a sharp sensation. But it is more predominantly mellow and relaxing and tame because there's nothing in this coffee that's really kicking and being more prominent. But overall, it just has like a nice finish to it. There's nothing that's being more predominant. You're not getting that lip puckering sourness like an espresso. For acidity, I'm gonna put this at about a 2 out of 5. Let's talk about aroma. So like with any Spanish coffees, you get that real prominent cinnamon in here. The first Spanish latte that I had actually had the real cinnamon inside in addition to the cinnamon additives. But this coffee, it doesn't have the stick. It just has the cinnamon added to it. So you're really getting that gingerbread and winter Christmas type of feeling. Now, the aroma is not as prominent as the other coffee because the Spanish latte is so creamy. It's providing just an overall nice creamy cinnamon aroma. I can get a little bit of that coffee aroma in addition to the cinnamon, but it's really hidden. You're not getting much of it. It's more predominantly cinnamon inspired. So if you love cinnamon, you're gonna love this coffee's aroma. Like with this previous coffee, it put me into a fall mood because of the pumpkin spice. This is bringing me into that Christmassy, wintry mood because of the cinnamon, because of like a cinnamon cookie. You know how the cinnamon spice gets associated with winter? That's what I'm getting. Drinking this coffee, I'm kind of slightly forgetting about the whole summer and spring LA weather. And it is attracting me for more. I love cinnamon. It's one of my favorite spices. The more I'm smelling this coffee, the more I want to keep going back into it and keep getting more of it and keep trying the coffee because the aroma is attracting me to go in for another taste as well. The aroma, you're getting that slight taste just by smelling it. It's kind of really close to the flavor. So what you're getting for the aroma, you're most likely gonna get in the flavor unless your taste buds are different. For aroma, I'm gonna give this a 4 out of 5. Next up is gonna be flavor. Like with the aroma, you're getting a real cinnamon flavor, but the creaminess of the coffee is making the flavor more mellow. You know, it's like a calm wave, and the cinnamon on top of it is just like slight bumps. So it's just the milk and the coffee is providing a nice creamy flavor. And then the cinnamon is just spicing up ever so slightly. It doesn't change it enough to distract you from that nice calm flavor. So you're not getting that huge cinnamon flavor as if you were biting into a cinnamon stick or if you were to eat like a Big Red or candies that have cinnamon in it. This is more toned down. It's just when you're drinking this coffee, you're getting that nice, tame, well-rounded cinnamon flavor. And it is kind of giving me like a chocolatey feeling. For some reason, when I'm thinking Spanish latte and I'm drinking this, I'm thinking of that nice, like earthy, chocolatey feeling and flavor, but you're also getting that spiciness because the cinnamon is a spice. Everything's kind of balancing in the right way. So the cinnamon is not taking over coffee in a way where it's obnoxious. And then the coffee and the milk are also not toning down anything else to kind of limit the real flavor of the coffee. When you're smelling it and you're tasting it, the flavor is getting enhanced by the aroma. So just that overall mood from the aroma and the nice feeling that it provides transitions to the flavor. So when you're drinking it, that nice feeling transitions to the flavor, and it overall provides a nice sensation and it enhances the taste buds in a big way. For flavor, I'm gonna give this about a 3.5 out of 5. So next up is gonna be body. So the overall feeling of the coffee does provide kind of like the top layer of water and just below soda. It's not giving that soda feeling just quite, but it is creamy enough to go to the top layer of water. But the other qualities of this coffee do change it to kind of trick you into making it feel like you are drinking a creamy coffee. But in reality, once you get rid of all those other sensations, it does feel like a water-like consistency. And there's the cinnamon spice in here. So you are getting a little bit of that spice on your tongue. So it is kind of grainy, but the graininess does add to the overall body and the texture in a huge way, because you're getting that creamy coffee feeling, but then you're getting that gritty addition to it because of the cinnamon. So it's combining in a positive way to overall make you feel like you're drinking an authentic Spanish latte. And because of that creaminess, since it is a water-like consistency, it does make it feel like there's a heavy feeling in here, like the milk was whipped and you're getting that kind of a feeling, but it's airy. So there is weight to it, but because it's airy, it is providing just that water-like consistency. And because the coffee is creamy, it does rest on your tongue and it does stick around for a long while. It doesn't dissipate quickly. Still get a little bit of that cinnamon coffee once the coffee's done, and just overall feeling on your tongue is there. But for body, I'm gonna give this about a 4 out of 5. Let's talk about sweetness. So because it's a Spanish latte and because it's cinnamon, it provides a little bit of that sour feeling, but the sour feeling does add to the sweetness. So it's not over the top sweet. It's around the same level of sweetness that I enjoy. So you know, the sweetness is right there. And then the sourness adds a little bit of an extra feeling to it to kind of change up the sweetness and make it better than just my overall norm. But it does maintain that consistency all throughout. So in the beginning of the coffee, you are getting that sweet flavor and you are getting a little bit of that sourness. And then as you're drinking the coffee and it's in your mouth and it goes away, it's still maintaining that same sweetness and sour level. The sourness doesn't become more pronounced and the sweetness more tame. It's just the same 75-25 from the beginning to the end. So for sweetness, I'm gonna give this a 4 out of 5. Next up is gonna be aftertaste. So like I mentioned with sweetness, it's still maintaining that sweetness and the sour all throughout. And it does have an overall nice feeling from the beginning to the end, but it does change texture wise and it does change feeling wise. Because the coffee is still in your mouth, it is lingering around and it is providing more of that milk in the coffee. So the cinnamon is kind of going away once the coffee's down your throat and it's finished. But the experience is nice. Although it changes, it does change for the better based off your preference. So some people might not like the coffee feeling in their mouth. Some people might. Some people would want that cinnamon flavor to stick around till the very end. Some people might want it to go away. So it's all based on your preference. For me, I like how the cinnamon kind of goes away because you're getting the best of both worlds. You are getting a nice cinnamon taste and aroma in the beginning, and then at the end, you are getting more of that coffee. So if you weren't able to pick up the coffee in the beginning, you are able to pick it up in the aftertaste. Because coffee is slightly sour, it does still coat your mouth and wet it. So once in your mouth, it's wetting it. And then once it's down your throat, it does provide that dry, slightly sour feeling because that's when the coffee really comes out. Since I typically don't add points because coffee changes, but since this changes for the better, it just overall makes me feel better, I'm gonna give aftertaste about a 4 out of 5. Next up, it's gonna be balance. The coffee does maintain the balance in the beginning and at the end, but from the whole process, it's not balanced because, as I mentioned, you are getting two different kind of experiences. One, initial aroma and taste and body, and then two, with the aftertaste and when it's coffee's already gone. It's great that it's not balanced, but since it does change, you are still able to figure out exactly what went into the coffee. You might not be able to do that if the coffee was the same all throughout and if it was completely balanced. You might not be able to pick up the milk or the coffee. You might just get the cinnamon all throughout, so it might kind of throw you off. but since it does change and since it is not balanced, you are able to pick up every ingredient and kind of figure out exactly what went into it. Since it is not balanced, it does all come together in the end to provide just a nice experience. So since it is unbalanced, it might have a harder time coming together perfectly at the end, but this coffee does a really good job at doing that. The first half all provides a nice, consistent feeling, and then the second half does the same, and then the two halves kind of merge together and create just a nice experience, just a nice overall feeling. For balance, I am gonna put this at about a 3.5 out of 5. But let's talk about complexity. Typically, Spanish lattes, not complex. The cinnamon was added to it, but that's not, you know, really out of the blue. You see a lot of cinnamon in a lot of coffees, but not many coffee shops do offer that Spanish latte experience. This coffee does a really good job at being a Spanish latte. Finding gems are really hard. I kind of lucked out and I've gone 2 for 2. So the places that I've been to and I've actually gotten a Spanish latte have all been hits. None of them have been misses. I would like to see the cinnamon stick in here. I would like to see a little bit of that nice Spanish presentation to it, kind of like the other coffee that I had. I would like the coffee cup to be more branded, no matter the size. So small, medium, and large. I would want the coffee cup to be the same branded. So it doesn't matter what size you get, you know, what kind of coffee shop you've been to. Because there was cinnamon sprinkled in here, it did look different. So it didn't have that typical brown look. It was more yellow, kind of like that turmeric coffee that I've had. So it was kind of that kind of a shade. For complexity, I'm gonna put this at about 2.5 out of 5. Let's talk about forgiveness. Like I mentioned with the complexity, since it's not complex, but because the coffee does come together in both sections perfectly, that is gonna get forgiven. So the overall aroma and the flavor, because they're so good and because they're so high up, they are gonna forgive the negatives in this coffee. You might not like the real the prominent cinnamon. So it's up to you to decide if the real positives in this coffee do actually forgive the negatives. Everybody has different positives. Everybody has different negatives. For forgiveness, I'm gonna put this at about 3.5 out of 5. Lastly, it's gonna be versatility. Since it's not super complex and it does have a good feeling to it, you could make this part of your daily. You could make this part of your weekend coffee as well, because the flavor's there, the aroma's there. For me, I'm not gonna save this coffee for special occasions. It's good enough to be my daily coffee or be my coffee that I get in the mornings and strictly in the mornings or strictly in the afternoons. I'm definitely gonna make the Spanish latte from Coffee Fix part of my rotation. For versatility, I am gonna put this at about a 4.5 out of 5. The Spanish latte from Coffee Fix got a 35.5 out of 50 or a 71% out of 100. Make sure you go to Coffee Fix in Studio City to get your own coffee fix of the Spanish latte. Tune in for more. Peace.